Barley and oats are the two most salt-tolerant annual crops producers can successfully plant on saline sodic areas in North Dakota. They will establish where other annual crops like canola or soybeans will not do well. Also, one of the worst things we could do to these saline sodic areas is to plant a crop that will not do well there. Planting crops on saline sodic areas that are not salt tolerant will not only result in loss of revenue, but it will also make the salinity and sodicity issues worse. In some cases, that may also lead to heavy weed pressure. Excess water-soluble salts compete with plant roots for water, whereas sodicity results in poor soil structure. Here at the Langdon REC, we have a saline sodic gradient that runs from east, where salt and sodicity levels are low compared to west, where there are very high levels of salinity and sodicity. In order to check at what salt and sodicity levels we could successfully plant barley and oat crops, we have planted 4 barley and 4 oat varieties in 3 replications. Barley varieties are Pinnacle, ACC Synergy, ND Genesis, and Tradition. Oat varieties include Rockford, CS Kempton, ND Hart, and Saras. First replication represent low salt and sodicity levels. The soil saturated paste electrical conductivity here is 3.99 and 7.32 millimoles per centimeter for the 0 to 6 and 6 to 24 inch soil depths. Sodium absorption ratio is 7.12 and 15.05 for the same soil depths. We could see that all barley and oat varieties have germinated well here. Also, when we were getting the seedbed ready, this area was very mellow compared to the other 2 replications. Though barley and oat varieties are quite salt tolerant compared to other annual crops, however, generally, once the soil EC levels in the topsoil get to 8 or more millimoles per centimeter, even these crops will not do well. That is what we can see in the second replication. The EC levels here are 7.8 and 10.39, whereas SAR levels are 18.13 and 20.92 for the 0 to 6 and 6 to 24 inch soil depths. So you can see the impact of higher surface salt and sodicity levels on barley and oat germination, which is quite poor compared to the first replication. Also, here when we were trying to get the seedbed ready, this area was difficult to till and there were big clumps. That is exactly what sodicity does to the soils, resulting in poor soil structure. Now, if we move on to the very high salt and sodicity replication or area, there's no germination at all, whether it's barley or oats. EC levels here are 10.5 and 9.86 with SAR levels of 27.3 and 32.87 for the 0 to 6 and 6 to 24 inch depths. This research trial shows us few things so far. Number 1, it is very helpful to analyze the soil salinity and sodicity levels before planting on these kind of unproductive areas. Number 2, we could profitably plant and grow barley and oats on areas with low to maybe moderate levels of salinity and sodicity. However, if the salt and sodicity levels become too high for even crops like barley and oats, then the best option will be to plant a mix of perennial salt-tolerant grasses.